Welcome to TheoTrade. This is Don Kaufman. It's April 18th, 2018. You were watching the Theo Night video. Just about 15 minutes left in the trading session with the S&Ps having a little bit of a lackluster trading session today, up about five handles and fading. We'll come back to that in just a few minutes. What I want to start with in this evening's video happens to be an incredibly large divergence in the broader marketplace. So you could call it a divergence in the force. It has to do with the financials kind of breaking away to the downside while the rest of the market has rallied back up. Now, let's take a little bit of a detailed look into not only a comparison chart, but also a bit about correlation. And we'll give you guys kind of a quick rundown on the differential between the comparison and the correlation. First of all, in a comparison chart, what we happen to be looking at here is none other than the spiders right on top here. So we'll go ahead and label this. Here's our SPY, and down below happens to be the XLF. Now, as I was saying, we're looking at a three-month daily chart, and the spider and the financials have moved literally in lockstep. They moved almost in perfect tandem motion. And that's not just being, you know, well, eyeball it and be like, all right, well, this looks like it's moving in perfect relative tandem motion. You can actually look at a study called correlation. And what a correlation coefficient does is they're either plus one or, for example, minus one. Plus one is an indication that one product is moving versus another at a rate roughly of 100%. It's 100% correlated. A minus one means it moves, again, perfectly inverted versus it. And what you're seeing is, you know, again, based on the last 3 months, they're moving in almost perfect tandem correlation. That's what this positive one indicates. Until, oh, albeit just recently, a fairly massive divergence in the force. Now, if you take a look, you know, over a vast period of time, even over 1 year, we've really had a large divergence. There are surely other divergences that have occurred, but the reason that this one not only grabs my attention, but really sparks interest, okay? Let's move away from this for just a moment is, well, number one, the financials. Let's just clean up the chart and go back to the financials. The financials are one of your largest sectors. Arguably, the financials are as large, if not larger, okay, in terms of market capitalization than technology. Everybody points to technology, okay? However, the financials have influence over some of the firms that are categorized in technology. Therefore, I always argue that, you know, when the financials move, it often moves the broader market. With that, the financials in just the last few days, you can see are kind of waning. However, when we go and we start to look at individual stocks that make up the financial sector, let's get to a number of them. For example, Bank of America. Now, Bank of America released, had fairly spectacular numbers. There's been sell side activity. JP Morgan, almost the exact same story. Releases, stock explodes up, ultimately falling back down by a fairly wide margin over here. Citi, the exact same story. Wells Fargo, an absolute disaster. That was prior to the earnings announcement. But today, we'll take a very similar approach to this. If you take a look at intraday trade on Morgan Stanley, when they released this morning, the stock had shot all the way to the 55 region, literally hitting 55 on the button and backsliding throughout the course of the day. And right now we're massively unchanged. People, the financials are in trouble. And to add a little bit of fuel to that fire, if you're like, oh, okay, so the financials are in trouble, who cares? Yeah, well, you also have the bonds backing off a full point today. Now, let's remind you that when the bond market is backing off, which it has been doing for the last couple of trading sessions, what do you have? You have rates, or the interest rates associated, going up. So a rising interest rate environment is, well, in a prototypical sense, good for financials. So this is something I was pointing out in the weekend video, is that you have every tailwind possible working for you in the financial sector. Everything. They've been deregulated. Check that box, because they have, right? They have the administration kind of on their side. They have several people now influencing the Fed. That's right. Jerome Powell came from the financial sector. I mean, we could go on for an hour about all of the tailwinds. Then you have taxation. Everything good apparently has already been priced into the financials and they continue to fall. And that's where we believe that weakness to the broader market could really come from, is specifically these financials. So looking at the broader market today, you can see the S&Ps are struggling. Now, let's go to the intraday trade for just a moment. The S&Ps have been up and up about 10 for a vast amount of today's trading session. You can see we're kind of waning into the close, which is just about 8 minutes away. So what gives? Well, what gives over here is specifically it's the financials, all right? In terms of technology, you have Amazon, but most of the other monsters of tech are really weak on a relative basis. And when we start looking a little bit more detailed into markets, and you guys will know I look at this quite often, this is the S&P 100 advanced decline line. We're shooting right down the middle here of about a 50-50 advanced decline line, which is unusual because lately we've seen 90 products up or 90 products down. What we're looking for as this week progresses, okay, is kind of the return of some volatility. And again, much of that being predicated on the fact that the financials are weak on a relative basis. Now, what has to occur, okay, for some of this volatility to return? Well, how are the S&Ps even up today? And this is a question you have to ask yourself. How are the S&Ps up with the financials weaker? Okay, and largely technology is kind of unchanged. You'll find the answer inside of the energy sector. Now, we're going to go over to the XLE. Now, this is a sector that I have been, you know, adamant and extraordinarily bullish upon. And I want to make this clear because the trade that I'm about to propose is not a bullish trade. So I have been very adamant, very bullish on the energy sector. I've been selling puts in the XLE. I have been selling puts in ExxonMobil in effort to try to get long the energy sector. However, what occurred is I sold those puts and the underlying exploded to the upside. Okay. Subsequently, I've now covered almost all of those puts. So in the short duration, and I don't want to confuse any longer duration positions from the short duration positions, because when I'm out there and I'm selling puts inside of the XLE, that is a longer duration take on being bullish, wanting to own the XLE or wanting to own, for example, ExxonMobil, ExxonMobil being the largest component in XLE. However, in the short duration, by any stretch and any measurement, we can say that XLE is probably in overbought territory. Now, what I've done, okay, assuming that I think that the XLE has, again, extended itself just a bit too far, a bit too fast. In fact, if you look at this on a year-to-date percentage, this is coming off being down 10% on a year-to-date basis. It's now unchanged. This is a 10% move straight up, okay? And that amounts to, and if you, again, if you just look back about 3 weeks in time, from 66 to almost 74, okay, what we have is it's a stellar move. I mean, in a 37-day period, you're only supposed to see just under about a $4 move. Here we are seeing almost an $8 move, okay? An $8 move in a 3 week period of time when a normal expected move is about $3.70 over a 37-day period. With that, I feel that there's going to be some sell side activity prevalent inside of the XLE, okay, in the next 37 days. And I've gone ahead and I've created an in-out spread. You can see I've been putting positions on and throughout the course of the trading session. Now, why did I select 37 days? Well, listen, on a position like this, you got to have time to be right, time to be wrong. So that's a position that I happen to encounter today. Obviously, the prices have changed dramatically. If you take a look, the time we put the position on was early in the day. We're seeing some sell side activity already. However, one of my primary focuses over the next couple of days is still going to be inside of the financials, which again threatens to take down the entire S&P. Let's look for that move to kind of occur after, again, a staggering move to the upside in the last couple of trading sessions. Here we are with one final look specifically at the SPX. What's most notable in the SPX, again, if we zoom in very, very tight over here, the marketplace, okay, happens to currently be trading just outside, again, just outside the weekly expected move in the SPX. Again, we believe it's, again, the XLF, the financial specifically, that is going to be pulling on the SPX back to the downside, along with the possibility of some sell side activity in the XLE. Thanks, everybody, for joining us here at TheoTrade. Have a wonderful evening. Bye-bye.